Hey guys, welcome back to CarnalDish. Today I'm going to show you how to make this killer low-carb spaghetti with mushroom and basil meat sauce. It's rich, it's versatile, super flavorful, and easy to recreate. Let's get started. Okay, first things first, you're going to add some olive oil and some butter to a very large skillet. And you're gonna let that get all nice and foamy. Then you're gonna add some of your favorite mushrooms. I'm using Hen of the Woods. They taste amazing. I love these mushrooms so much. Gonna add some more fat just to make sure that they are evenly coated in a thin layer. They should not be swimming in fat, but they should all be glistening a little bit. You're gonna add some salt and pepper to this and make sure that they're well seasoned. Toss that around. And then you're gonna arrange them in the skillet so that they have contact. And that contact is what's gonna give them some brownness. So walk away and let them do their thing for about 5 to 6 minutes. When you come back and flip them, they're gonna look like this, or they should look like that. If they don't, then you need to let them chill out on the skillet some more. But you basically just wanna toss them around, let them caramelize until they're all golden and beautiful. Oh God, I love mushrooms so much. If you don't love mushrooms, you know, you can leave them out, but that's your bad. Anyway, remove them from the skillet and you're gonna add some more fat. So some more olive oil, a little bit more butter, because this time we're gonna saute our onions. And when you add the onions, they're gonna like do their thing to where all their juices and their liquid start to release, and then what's gonna happen is gonna pick up that yummy flavor that the mushrooms left stuck to the bottom of the skillet, and it's gonna absorb back into the onions. So add some salt and pepper as I did here, and just leave them alone. Let them cook for about 5 minutes until they're softened. And now we're gonna add the ground beef. And you can use turkey, you can use ground chicken, whatever you like. But you just want to break that up with the back of your spoon, just until it's in like chunks. And I'm going to go ahead and season this up now. I like to season ground beef when it's kind of pink and brown because it kind of absorbs into the meat better. So I'm adding my favorites, Herb de Provence, crushed red pepper flakes, salt, pepper, garlic, onion powder, all that stuff. Just get it all up in there, toss everything around. At this point I realized that I should have used a larger skillet, but whatever, we're gonna make it do what it do. So just keep pushing, make sure that you break all that meat down. You see all that liquid? We're gonna let that evaporate. Okay, so it's gonna take about maybe 7 to 10 minutes. Just keep cooking it. All the liquid will, you know, evaporate, and you'll be left over with some really good beef fat, okay? It shouldn't be too much, but just enough to coat everything. And you're gonna add your garlic here and let that garlic cook for about maybe 2 to 3 minutes. If you don't use sliced garlic, you can definitely use minced, but do not use that garlic in the jar, okay? I will come and find you. It is disgusting. So let's use fresh garlic, folks. So we're gonna add the mushrooms back to this mixture. Toss everything around, add the thyme, let that get all nice and happy for about a minute or two. Now I'm adding the tomato paste, and I'm also gonna add a little squirt of anchovy paste. Totally optional. I know a lot of people don't have that in their pantry, but it's a staple. It's really good in tomato-based sauces. Gives it like such a punch of umaminess. It's just, oh, delicious. So we're gonna let the tomato paste kind of toast up and get like a rusty brown color. And then we're gonna deglaze the bottom of the pan with some wine. I'm using rosé here. You can use red, you can use a stock, you can use water. It doesn't really matter. Use whatever you have. If you don't drink, like I said, you can use water. So I drained off all the liquid from some diced tomatoes and I added those, and now I'm adding a can of crushed tomatoes. And you just wanna gently mix everything together, and you're gonna let this simmer covered for about 10 to 15 minutes, okay? Over about medium low to low heat, all right? So cover that up, then you come back, stir it all together. If you notice that anything is sticking at the bottom of the skillet, this is the moment that you want to bump the heat down just a little bit, okay? And I had to do that. So I put the heat on low. Now it's coming along perfectly. It's getting all thick and delicious. And you just want to season the sauce with maybe a little bit more garlic and onion powder to punch up those flavors. Don't add any sweeteners yet. I'm adding some salt here, but don't add any sweeteners yet, because the longer that this cooks, the sweeter the tomatoes will become on their own. So I'm adding a drizzle of balsamic vinegar here, just a little bit, because balsamic vinegar also has a little bit of sugar in it, so you just want to be careful with that. Now I'm adding my favorite, just a little bit of basil pesto. I'm telling you, when you put this in your tomato sauce, it just takes it to a whole nother level. Of course, if you have a nut allergy, please don't add that to your sauce, but it is so bomb when you put it in tomato sauce. And just let that cook. You know, this whole thing took about maybe 35 to 45 minutes to cook, just to develop and deepen those flavors. And now I turn the heat off and I'm adding some grated pecorino romano cheese that I grated myself, a little bit of fresh herb. And for the most part, this sauce is completely done, okay? So we're just gonna set that to the side and we're gonna cook our shirataki noodles. Now the shirataki noodles that I like to use are the tofu shirataki noodles. They are the best tasting in my opinion, and I've tasted them all. These are bomb, okay? These also closely resemble like real pasta to me more than the other ones. Now just like any shirataki noodle that you purchase, you really want to rinse these off because they kind of have like a fishy smell to them. They're not the most pleasant smelling right out of the package, so make sure you rinse them really well, toss them around, and we're gonna evaporate any leftover liquid and basically kill any leftover odor by giving it a high roast in a nonstick skillet over high heat. So a dry skillet over high heat. You just want to keep swishing them around until you no longer see any liquid. I'm adding some salt here just to season them up. Now eventually it's going to get to the point where you start to see, you see that residue at the top? Like, that's when you know that they're done and they're completely dry, okay? And that's all we want to go for here. And at that point, plate your food up. You're going to hit it with some more fresh herbs, some grated cheese. Oh, you're going to love this recipe, I promise. It is so good. You can easily swap out things that you don't like, or, you know, use a different mushroom. It's totally your call, but you're going to love this one, I promise. I hope you guys enjoyed this recipe. Give this video a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. She make you wanna lick the plate. I know you love the way it tastes. Carnal dishes.